So what we're gonna do is just change out this keyed entry door lock here. As you can see, there's some damage, some existing damage here. So that might pose a bit tricky, because this is a little jank to be quite honest with you. But what's going on is that you put the key in, and sometimes it's just spinning, and the key is getting stuck, and you have to wiggle and get it out to get it loose. So I wanted to exchange that, but I'm thinking now that it might be this might also be contributing to the issue. So I can go ahead and take this apart, at least for the time being. So this was a Kwikset, quick little easy lock. Takes only about, you can get these at a home department store, 10, 12 bucks or something. So we'll go ahead and replace that. All you do is just simply disassemble. All you need is a Phillips. Take the screws out. This should be a quick quick setup here. Should be able to get this done in a matter of 5 minutes, 5-10 minutes, give or take. It'll be a lot easier, a lot faster, a lot smoother if it wasn't so damaged. Working on a lot of damaged pieces here, so this might be interesting, to say the least. Let's go to my screw. the new lock. We won't be using that. Got our screws. We got our basic, simple instructions. But as you can see, it's pretty self-explanatory for the most part. Pretty simple. So what we want to do is put in there. Okay. There we go. As you see, you press that in and it gives you a bit more space. Sometimes it's important to read the instructions. It won't go all the way through because the kind of the jankiness of the door. So again, this will be a lot faster if this was if this door was set. How it looks.
See that? Not really crazy about how that looks, but
just for the sake of the video. Now slide it away from the door. We're gonna use these two longer screws. Comes with a set of six screws, four of these smaller ones, two of these longer ones, and those are the ones we want to insert.
Yes, and the girl's been at work with us for a week.
Mom, I'm recording for you. Just give me.
Yeah, go.
at 15 minutes. 15 minutes and we shouldn't be. But I wanted to show you this in real time. In case you run into snags like this yourself. There you have it. Let's get out. Let's do the use the key. Make sure that that's nice. So that's locked. You see, it's not moving. The key out. There you go. That's good. So that works now. I do think that I'm inclined to wanting to put like a longer screw there just for safe measure, because these short screws didn't seem to really hold. And then this is quite old. Thing is that let's see look how junk that is. It's all bent up and you see the curve. But these screws are long. Kind of contemplating on using those. Catch on anything, so I'll have to, unfortunately I may have to go back to using this. I can try to flatten it. I just don't like the way it sits. It's so, grab the keys just in case. Thank you. need work. So that's locked. That they had, because I'm not crazy about this being super secure, because these nails are, these screws are so short that I don't think that it's I think over time these are just, it's not really securely holding these screws in. So I'll put these old screws back in it. The ones, see, this is quite short. These ones, which were not even the same size, that one's probably 2.5 inches, and this one is about an inch. So we definitely have to get the appropriate screws. Bubbles out, so it's not hitting flush. this lock now. Apologies, that should not have taken that long, but gotta do what you gotta do sometimes. This is just a temporary fix. We'll get a new system squared away.